which new nuclear reactors were connected to the grid in 2023? I'll tell you about them in this video in chronological order. On January 10th, the Fangchenggang 3 unit in China was connected to the grid, and since March it has already been put into commercial operation. It took 8 years to build it. It is a Chinese-designed pressurized water reactor HPR-1000, also known as Hualong One or Chinese Dragon, featuring a 1,180 megawatts capacity. It stands as the initial installation of two at this location and marks the third Hualong One in China, the fifth globally, with Pakistan hosting the earlier two. The unit became the 55th operating nuclear power plant unit in China. Now there is only one less than in France, but they already generate significantly more electricity, second only to the United States in this indicator. On January 31st, Mohav's Unit 3 in Slovakia was connected to the grid. It installed a Soviet-designed VVR-440 reactor with a capacity of 440 megawatts. The construction itself has been a long-term construction since 1987, resumed in 2008. Then it was planned that it would be completed by 2013. The unit has become the fifth in the country and the third on this site. It was built mainly by EU countries and companies, especially the Czech Škoda, but not without the participation of Russia, and it uses Russian nuclear fuel. Mohav's 3 increased the number of nuclear units within the EU operating on Russian nuclear fuel from 18 to 19. The unit was put into commercial operation only in the fall of 2023, not without problems during development. Still, nevertheless, the unit managed to increase the output of nuclear power plants in Slovakia in 2023 by 15%. Mohav's 3 became the only new grid-connected unit within the European Union in 2023. Before this, within the EU, a year earlier, the Finnish Olkiluoto 3 was connected to the grid, which was put into commercial operation in 2023. On March 31st, the Vogtle 3 unit in the USA was connected to the grid. It took 10 years to build, from 2013. Vogtle 3 became the first unit built in the United States with an AP1000 Generation 3 Plus reactor from Westinghouse, and only the third new nuclear unit which started operation in the United States over the past 30 years. It has faced long delays and cost overruns, becoming one of the most expensive nuclear units in the world. But it is nonetheless a landmark event for the US nuclear industry, and another unit is on the way on the same site. On May 13, the second unit of the Belarusian NPP with the Russian VVR-1200 reactor was connected to the grid. It was put into commercial operation in November. Thus, the two-block Belarusian NPP was completed, the first NPP with VVR-1200 reactors built by Russian nuclear corporation Rosatom abroad. Its construction was also accompanied by delays. Nevertheless, two units of this nuclear power plant produced more than 12 billion kilowatt hours of electricity in 2023, which is three times more than the output of this nuclear power plant in 2022. And this raised the share of generated nuclear electricity in Belarus to 30% of total consumption versus about 10% a year earlier. Well, as the last connection in 2023, we can name two Japanese units at the Takahama NPP, 780 megawatts BWRs, which were reconnected to the grid at the end of summer after 12 years of inactivity. Moreover, the blocks are already more than 50 years old. Before the relaunch, they were the first in Japan to receive work permits up to 60 years of age. Let me remind you that before the accident at the Fukushima nuclear power plant in 2011, more than 50 nuclear power units were operating in Japan, which provided more than 30% of the country's electricity. After the accident, they were stopped until necessary inspections, modernization, and permits were obtained from the government and local authorities. Since then, 10 units have been restarted, and in 2023, two more were added to them. About 20 more are in the process of obtaining permits. In total, in 2023, six nuclear units in five countries with a total capacity of just over 5 gigawatts were connected to the grid for the first time or after a break. In further results for 2023, we will discuss how many units were decommissioned and how much new construction was started. And also the most important thing is how much electricity production has changed at nuclear power plants around the world and in individual countries. Although this is more difficult, since these statistics do not come so quickly, many interesting things can be said now. More on this in the next videos. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out.